the dipole will not experience any force because force on both the arms will be equal and opposite, hence cancel out, but will experience a torque whose magnitude is P cross E. P is the dipole moment and this E is the direction of electric field. So there would be a torque. Okay, this will try to rotate it until unless P is parallel or anti-parallel. So what will happen if this P is parallel to this or anti-parallel to this? In that case there will be a no rotation condition. There will be a no rotation condition and it will not try to rotate, because in that condition the sine theta is either sine 0 degree or sine 180 degree, hence torque will be 0 for both sine 0 degree or sine 180 degree, because this is a cross product and in cross product we take sine theta. So sine 0 means there will be no torque, hence this will not rotate. If the dipole direction is either parallel to electric field or opposite to the electric field, this is 0 degree condition, this is 180 degree condition. In both the cases there will be no torque on this dipole, hence it will not rotate, but for any other angle it will rotate. Now suppose we apply some external torque, there is some internal torque because of this electric field and this dipole, and we apply some external torque T external. Okay, that we are applying this in a manner that it just neutralizes just this torque. So if there is one torque and we apply another torque, this tau external, another torque, external torque which neutralizes this torque and rotates it in plane of paper from angle theta naught to theta 1. So we are applying another torque which is moving it from theta naught to theta 1. So first we have considered there is some torque P cross E. Now we are applying some external torque and this external torque is neutralizing the first torque and rotate this from angle theta naught to theta 1 at an infinitesimal angular speed. That means this word infinitesimal means very 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 small. Please note it down, in physics you will see this word again. This is very 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 small. That means we can neglect this. So there is no effect of this angular speed. This is so small that we can neglect this speed, and without angular acceleration. So there is no angular speed and no angular acceleration. It is only, as we previously considered, that external force. If you remember that particle example where we were bringing this test charge into external an electric field of capital Q charge. So we said that the force is so that it only cancels out the repulsive force. Hence there is no velocity and no acceleration. Velocity is very small and acceleration is zero. Acceleration is zero and velocity is very 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 less. This velocity is very very less and acceleration is zero. So force is so low. Similarly here torque is such that the angular velocity is very very low and angular acceleration is zero. Angular acceleration is zero, alpha is zero, and this angular velocity omega is very 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 less. This is very very less. Okay, and this angular acceleration is zero. Now similar to that it was force and you took linear velocity and acceleration, normal acceleration. Now here force is replaced by tau, torque, velocity is replaced by angular velocity and acceleration is replaced by angular acceleration. Both of them were zero, both of them are very small, and these were only such that they cancel the effect of natural. Here the natural torque is cancelled, there the natural force, electrostatic force was cancelled by external force. So these are the conditions. So let me remove these. Now in this case, the amount of work done by the external torque. Now let us calculate the what is the amount of work done. So work done is simply, so tau external into theta. So theta, so this theta is that means this tau external, that external torque is dependent on theta. This is in bracket. So this whole thing is one quantity. This is showing that this tau external is dependent on theta. This bracket means that, okay. So these are not two quantities, but one, that tau external is dependent on theta. So if this is the external torque which is trying to rotate it, theta means it is trying to rotate it, and it rotates at a very small angle d theta. Very small angle d theta. Then we integrate. So total rotation from theta 0 to theta 1, and we are integrating it. Now the value of this tau external is p cross e, and again this is cross product, so we can take sine theta. So the value of this tau external is p e sine theta. Thus infinitely small angle is d theta, and total rotation is from theta 0 to theta 1. Let us take what can come outside. Since this is integration over d theta, this p and e is constant. So let us take this outside, p and e. Now integration remains for theta 0, theta naught to theta 1, and sine theta d theta. Okay. And now the integration of sine theta is, integration of sine theta is minus cos theta. Integration of sine theta is minus cos theta. So this will come out as p e minus cos theta, and theta 1 theta 0. Okay. So first let us apply this upper limit. So when we apply upper limit, this p e is common. Minus cos theta 1 plus minus cos theta 1, and minus this second limit, cos theta naught. So again there is already a minus, so this will become plus cos theta naught. So let us take this first. So this is cos theta naught minus cos theta 1. So total work done is this. Total work done is this, PE cos theta naught minus cos theta 1. This is the total work done. Total work done in moving this with some external torque from an angle theta naught to theta 1. Okay. Again, listen this. This is the total work done in rotating an electric dipole in external electric field E from angle theta naught to theta 1 with the help of some external torque TEXT. Okay. With external torque, we have rotated from theta naught to theta 1 in external electric field E. So this is the total work done. Now again, you know this work will be stored as potential energy. This work done will be stored as potential energy. This much you know till now. We can then associate potential energy mu theta. So let us put this u theta at with an inclination of theta of the dipole. So let us put this PE cos theta naught minus cos theta. Here they have taken theta naught is equal to pi by 2, and theta 1 is equal to theta. Why they have taken this pi by 2? Again, cos pi by 2 is 0. Cos pi by 2 is 0. Similar to that, as potential at infinity was 0, so we have chosen a value of theta where potential energy or potential is 0.